What's up, Jack Shit?
Man, when in the fuck are you gonna grow up? You're the only one that still calls me that shit.
Yeah, because that's who the fuck you are. Jack Shit. And I've got your shit, Jack.
Just put it on the table.
Yo. So what the hell are you working on?
Yeah, just fucking around with an idea.
What is it this time? Do something useful, like cook some dope for me.
Because I'd rather create than destroy.
What the fuck's that supposed to be?
Like I said, I'd rather create than destroy. Man, this shit you're doing, it's fucking people's lives up. I'm not about that.
Yeah, you're one to fucking talk, dude. I'm down here once a week destroying you. Oh yeah, and you're the one that asked for it.
Well, that's different. I use it to drive my work.
Drive your work? Dude, what makes you different than any other tweaker on the street? I mean, just because you're not a junkie no more, that don't mean that you're clean. This shit, it'll rot your fucking brain, man. What is you, ignorant?
Ignorant. Just think of all the creative minds, all chemically enhanced. What do you have? You have Cobain, you have Hendrix,
Coltrane.
I mean, the list goes on.
Yeah. They're all dead because of it.
They died before they had a chance to get clean. Man, if they would have gotten clean, they would have sucked. Oh, here's a good example. Aerosmith. I mean, just think about their first five or six albums. Right? Good stuff, right? All right. They got clean. Guess what happened? They sucked. Oh, yeah, and Coltrane? He got clean. And guess what? He sucked, too.
Dude, you're talking about musicians. And, dude, you're not just sitting there playing a guitar or nothing, man. You're fucking with wires and shit.
Well, that's where you're wrong, my dope-dealing friend. I mean, you have Bela Lugosi, Edgar Allan Poe, Sherlock Holmes, and the guy that created the Statue of Liberty. What was his name? French guy. Hell, I don't know. Anyway, he was a fucking cokehead.
Dude, Sherlock Holmes ain't even fucking real.
Yeah? Abraham Lincoln, is he real? He bought a bag of cocaine for 50 cents in 1860.
Whatever, dude. You never did answer my fucking question.
About what?
What the fuck are you working on, man?
Alright. Here, I'll show you. You see this? You see, this is an analog theremin controlled by electrical brain. Quit. Electrical brain impulses generated from the frontal precortex. Quit. Stop it. Damn it. You see, the frontal precortex is thought to be the orchestrator of intellectual thoughts and actions. Man, that's the place where dreams come from. You understand?
What the fuck, dude?
Okay, you know what a theremin is, right? Come here. Okay, you know those horror films, you got that, what's that sound? Okay, well, this is not exactly a theremin, but it's kind of like one, all right? Okay, you see how my... See how the tone changes pitch when I put my hand across it? See, they ain't no big deal. It just uses a photocell. I mean, you can get one of them on the internet kit, you know, cheap. I just made this out of junk. It's not no big deal.
Dude, cool.
Anyway, okay, let me, come here. Come here. You see what I'm trying to do? Uses the basic same principles, but instead of using a photocell, which works on varying light levels, it's controlled by brain waves, man. You see what I mean?
Dude, fucking awesome. So you like think the music, right?
Exactly. Exactly.
Oh, sweet.
Exactly.
What are you going to do with it? I mean, what good is it, you know? Nah, dude, I was just wondering, like, well,
we'll
you
see
know,
you next week.
I mean, seriously.
Go ahead, leave.
Thank you.
Jack Schmidt Cooking Show. So happy you could be here. I love you very much. Now, we are going to continue our liver mush omelette that we had talked about earlier. And liver mush is a component of, actually it's a manufactured meat of multiple components of pig flesh. And pig flesh is important in the south of the United States. Now, pig flesh, otherwise known as liver mush, is so wonderful to eat when it's cooked in an omelet. Now, to make the liver mush omelet perfectly, you have to have the perfect liver mush.
I like that.
You must have
that's good.
The pig ears, the pig snout, the pig intestines, and other pig parts. But most importantly, the pig liver. The pig liver cannot be compromised. The pig liver has to be so fatty and wonderful that it just creates all kind of wonderfulness for you. Once you have the perfect liver mush, here's what you will do with it. First, you take your eggs and you crack them right into the pan. And then you scramble them up. Let me get my scrambler. Scramble them up. And once you get them scrambled up, you put a little salt and a little pepper right into the pan. Right in there. Just scramble up. Now, liver mush. You take your big chunk of liver mush that you bought in the store and you get ready to slice you off a one great big hunk of it. Just big enough, like a deck of cards. Pull that over, bring it over here when your eggs are nice and firm, and just crumble it. Right there, on top of the eggs. The smell is amazing. That's about it, but if you wanna, you can just flip it over with a spatula. And then we'll take it and we'll dump it over here on our plate. Okay? That's a liver mush omelet. Now, I know what you're saying. You're saying, Jack Schmidt, what the fuck are you talking about? Well, this is boring, so let's go into something a little bit more interesting, shall we? Have you ever heard of speed? Now, I ain't talking about the speed, the stuff that you get in the little white pills, or the Black Beauties, or the 357 Magnums. No, I'm talking about real crystal meth, all right?
and I'm going to show y'all how that you can make it safely in your own home. And this is the same drug, got to remember now, the same drug that Adolf Hitler used on his troops to make them work and play and kill and everything for days and days and days on end without having to sleep or anything. So it helped him a whole lot. Well, in the end, not so much, but it helped them to continue on with fewer people. So anyway, crystal meth. I got a list of ingredients right here I want to give to you. All right. Hydrochloric acid. Very important that you get this somewhere safe. All right. So because if you don't have it, or if you don't know what hydrochloric acid is, it's called lye, okay? Just go get you some lye from the hardware store, all right? Now, sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide's real easy. That shit is under your sink. It's called drain cleaner. Check it out. Read the label, sodium hydroxide. Next ingredient is ethyl ether. Ethyl ether, okay? Now, ethyl ether, you could probably get down at the local mall warp because ethyl ether is starting fluid. You just go get you a can down there at Malwart, all right? Now, final thing you need is nasal inhalers, okay? Now, nasal inhalers, any of them will work. It's a little tube you shove up your nose when you can't breathe, all right? So get some of them. Now, you're also going to need to assemble all this stuff, all of our nice little assembly of chemistry set type stuff here. Now, you need some vials, you need some litmus paper, you need some big beakers, and of course you're going to need some chemicals and some magnesium dioxide. All right, now mortar and pestle is optional, okay? Now we're going to proceed to the steps of putting this together. All right, so Jack, are you listening to me? Jack, are you getting all this? Jack, hey Jack, Jack, hey Jack.
Hell you want?
The hell you think I want, dude?
It's your weekly drop-off day.
Saturday? Already?
Damn, dude, you look like shit.
I've been working a lot.
Working on what, your creation? Dude, you need to get some sleep. Quit smoking this shit. And I got some weed, man.
Just give me my shit!
Damn, dude, what happened to your finger?
I cut myself shaving!
Oh, that is nasty! What's up with that hole in it?
I smashed it, so I stuck a hole in it to let the pressure out. You gotta go.
What?
Go! Get out of my fucking house! Go!
Dude, you're fucked up, man. You need help.